The U.S. Army intends to buy 2 batteries of Israel's Iron Dome defense system. The plan is to buy 12 launchers, 2 associated radars, a pair of battle management systems, and 240 individual Tamir interceptors. The total cost is around $370 million, of which U.S. Army wants to have $290 million allocated from its existing 2019 budget and remaining $80 million from 2020 budget. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why U.S. Army wants to have Israel's Iron Dome defense system. Let's get into the details. Russia and China have invested a lot of effort in cruise missile technology and are at par or even a step ahead in some aspect when compared to America in this field. The U.S. Army, as well as the Congress, is well aware of the threat from short as well as long-range cruise missiles. This has been underlined in the last U.S. National Defense Strategy, which was released in January 2018 by the Pentagon. Further in the annual defense policy bill for the 2019 fiscal year, Congress made it a legal binding for the U.S. Army to have 2 batteries of an air defense system dedicated for protection against cruise missiles. These are to be made operational by 2020. Israel's Iron Dome has been chosen for this purpose. It's a mobile, all-weather air defense system developed by Rafael Advanced Defense Systems and Israel Aerospace Industries. For Israel, Iron Dome's main objective is to neutralize rockets and other artillery rounds. But for U.S. Army, it will act primarily as a defense against cruise missiles. It's been reported by Inside Defense that U.S. Army's top procurement official, Bruce Jett, has sent details to members of Congress for consideration. The Times of Israel quoted Jett saying, "We want to have some things in place that provide us some immediate protection. So what that's going to do is we're going to look at things that are readily available." As per reports, 2 other options have been evaluated. First is the National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile Systems, NASAMS. This is a joint effort between America's Raytheon and Norway's Kongsberg. Second is the upgraded variant of Multi-Mission Launcher, MML. It's still in the works. Iron Dome was selected as it satisfied all requirements, including the cost. The Iron Dome weapon system is the lowest layer of Israel's multi-layered air and missile defense umbrella. It has a first-of-its-kind multi-mission launcher that's designed to fire a variety of interceptor missiles. The interceptor is chosen depending on the threat. Iron Dome's Tamir interceptor missiles can strike down incoming threats launched from ranges of 4 to 70 kilometers. Tamir missiles are equipped with electro-optical sensors and steering fins with proximity fuse blast warheads. Each battery includes 3 to 4 stationary launchers with 20 Tamir missiles and a battlefield radar. A single battery can defend up to nearly 60 square miles. Iron Dome is considered to be the most used missile defense system. 10 Iron Dome batteries protect Israel. According to Israel, it's been used to intercept more than 1,500 targets, with a greater than 90% success rate since it was deployed in 2011. Though the data regarding success rate is often challenged by critics, but there's no doubt the system has seen extensive real-world usage. As recently as the 20th of January 2019, the system is reported to have knocked out incoming rocket launched from Syria. Currently, U.S. Army's primary air defense weapon is the Patriot surface-to-air missile system, but Patriot Interceptor cost around $2 million each. U.S. Army is in need of something that's much cheaper so that enough quantity of Interceptor could be deployed. This is where Iron Dome comes into the picture. Tamir Interceptor used by Iron Dome has a reported unit cost of $100,000 to $150,000. This means a battery of Iron Dome consisting of 20 Tamir interceptors can be deployed for the cost of about a single Patriot interceptor missile. This makes it far more cost-effective. Another important aspect is that Iron Dome is readily available to America. Iron Dome has received quite a bit of funding from U.S. government, and America's Raytheon actually manufactures 70% of Tamir Interceptor. The fact that it's seen significant usage, is low cost, and is immediately available makes the Iron Dome a perfect solution for U.S. Army's needs.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.